morning everyone. Today I'm going to teach you chapter 11, which is measurement and motion. We already finished first four chapter, which is source of food, component of food, fiber to fabric, sorting material into groups. Okay, let us proceed into 11th chapter, which is measurement and motion. In this chapter we will discuss about physical quantities, measurements, standard units, need for accurate measurements, measurements of length, importance of estimation, what is motion, story of transport, types of motion, different motion at same time. Okay, so let's start this chapter. Class 6, chapter 11, which is measurement and motion. Measurement and motion. We often come across questions such as how long is the cricket pitch, how much sugar did you buy, how much milk is there at home, how long did you return from school. To give an accurate reply to these questions, you need to a measure of length, mass, volume or time period. Okay, sometimes you make no guess without measuring, but your guess may turn out be wrong. Okay, as will be clear from the following examples where it is difficult to make the proper guess. Okay, so that's why we need to a required measurement. Measurement will show that in figure 11.1 a all the lines are equal in length, and in a figure 11.1b both the glass have an equal volume of juice. In our daily life we make measurement all the time. A shopkeeper measure the amount of sugar he sell you. Whenever we go to any shop, we say to shopkeeper that give me 5 kg of sugar. This 5 kg is the measurement of sugar. If I am going to buy 5 meter of cloth, then 5 meter is the measurement of cloth. If we say today I walk around 2 km, this 2 km is a measurement. So everything need a measurement. Okay, a person at a petrol pump measure the volume of petrol he fill in your car, and a doctor measures your body temperature when you are ill. Not only sugar measure, also petrol measure, temperature measure. In school time is measured so that each period begins at on time. Thus measurement are important in our life. By this paragraph we understand the importance of measurement in our daily life, how measurement play important role while measuring the distance between two objects, measuring any substance like sugar, salt, measuring time period of classes in school, measuring temperature of the body, measuring what amount of petrol fill in the car. So we वी नीड टू एक्यूरेट मेजरमेंट ऑफ दीज क्वांटिटीज. टॉपिक इज, फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज. Let us see what is physical quantity. Think of four different things you measure in your daily life, and you measure a length of a line segment, the time during the day, the weight of vegetables bought from a vegetable seller, the temperature during the day to see how hot or cold is it, the speed of car you travel in. These all things are known as quantities. Quantities like length, weight, time, temperature and speed that can be measured are known as physical quantities. So this is the definition of physical quantity. You need to write down in your notebook. Okay. Long ago, people used the foot step and the hand palm or the arm to the measure length like that. One arm. We can say that the length of this board is 2 arm. Okay, so in early stage of people, long ago people, they are measuring from this way. But these units or measurement are unreliable because they are varying from person to person. If my hand is shorter than any other person, then the length is varying. They have not accurate value. There was a need for a unit of measurement which could be uniformly used by everyone, and such unit is known as standard unit. Okay. Which could be uniformly used. By everyone. Are called स्टैंडर्ड मूवी।